During 2022, seven volcanoes within Russia's Kamchatka Peninsula and adjacent Kuril Islands have produced explosive eruptions, marking the area as one of the planet's most volcanically active regions, as it is part of the Ring of Fire. However, in recent weeks, three of these volcanoes which were erupting ceased their eruptions, one of which was the Russian equivalent of Mount St. Helens, the Bezimiani volcano. Then, on November 19th, a moderate magnitude 5.1 earthquake occurred 50 kilometers off of Kamchatka's coastline. This quake seemingly triggered not only a dramatic increase in the eruptive intensity of the Sheveluch volcano, but also caused a new volcanic eruption of Russia's 15,584-foot, or 4,750-meter-tall snow-covered volcano Klyuchevskoy. While Klyuchevskoy has a history of mostly moderately sized explosive eruptions, the same cannot be said of the volcano Sheveluch. For example, one such major eruption occurred in 1964. During that eruption, 1.5 cubic kilometers of the volcano collapsed in a massive landslide, generating a Plinian eruption column with material from the landslide and pyroclastic flows traveling up to 18 kilometers or 11 miles distant. Since then, a large lava dome has grown within the collapse scar. This lava dome has produced frequent volcanic explosions where part of the lava dome collapsed or was blown upwards, resulting in numerous pyroclastic flows. Several of these pyroclastic flows since 2000 were quite voluminous, as at least two visible deposits traveled beyond 14 kilometers from Sheveluch's summit. Although Sheveluch has been continuously erupting for several years, the vast majority of its ongoing eruptive activity is only moderate in volume, where intermittent explosions eject ash to a height of under 10,000 meters and producing several kilometer-long pyroclastic flows. However, on occasion, this volcano produces larger eruptions known as paroxysms, which are 1 to 3 orders of magnitude larger than an average eruption. These generally occur when a significant quantity of shallow magma and gas is unable to escape due to the massive overlying rock and the growing lava dome. Once this reaches a certain threshold, a large segment of overlying rock breaks, causing a large eruption to occur. At Sheveluch, another such paroxysm might occur in the next several hours, days, or weeks, as in the past week, an increasing number of heat signatures have been detected from satellite. Such an eruption could temporarily disrupt air traffic and cause large amounts of ash to fall to the east or northeast. Meanwhile, the towering Klyuchevskoy volcano, which is best recognizable through its highly symmetrical volcanic cone, erupted anew around November 19th. This latest eruption has consisted of single to low double-digit intermittent explosions each hour, where strombolian activity ejects bombs of lava in a modest radius. So far, this eruption has largely been confined to its summit crater, but this could change as the eruption continues. Klyuchevskoy during eruptions is frequently the site of bright orange glowing lava flows that descend its flanks, providing a gorgeous contrast in coloration, and is often visible for dozens of kilometers. Although this eruption may seem somewhat harmless, the volcano should still not be approached for any reason. Larger Volcanian or subplinian eruptions have occurred at Klyuchevskoy, resulting in pyroclastic flows which have traveled several kilometers down its flanks. As a whole, Klyuchevskoy is one of the most active volcanoes in all of Russia, as its modern volcanic cone only began forming 7,000 years ago. It is located in close proximity to five active volcanoes such as Tolbochik and Bezimiani, in addition to a dormant volcano. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron Sandra Antoniak for supporting this channel.